Like and subscribe right now, or you're gonna have terrible luck for the next week.
A tsunami can move as fast as 500 miles per hour or 800 kilometers per hour and can have a devastating effect on everything in its path. A powerful earthquake triggered the 2011 tsunami off the Japanese coast, which caused the death of 18,000 people, and the 2004 Boxing Day tsunami in the Indian Ocean absolutely devastated the region, causing over 220,000 deaths and billions of dollars in property damage. The immense power of a tsunami draws up debris and creatures from the deep sea that typically don't see the light of day. Here follows a list of 12 mysterious creatures and items that have washed up after a tsunami. Number 12. A rowboat. Although it may not seem a big deal to find a rowboat washed ashore after a powerful wave, the rowboat that turned up on a beach in Washington State in 2013 had traveled a long way. It was discovered to be a Japanese boat that had ripped its moorings in the 2011 tsunami and washed out to sea. The boat remarkably drifted for 2 years in the Pacific Ocean before landing on the beach in Washington. Unsurprisingly, the boat was covered in barnacles and seaweed, and one of the compartments was filled with water. An amazing discovery was made in the water-filled compartment in the form of 5 striped blackfish. The fish were still very young and measured only 5 inches or 13 centimeters long. The theory is that the fish were swept into the compartment as larvae and had been surviving inside ever since. Number 11. A giant eyeball. This one's pretty gross. A beachcomber discovered a softball-sized blue eyeball on the sand in Pompano Beach, Florida in 2012. There was a lot of initial speculation as to what creature this eyeball belonged to, with state wildlife officials in Florida baffled by the giant orb. The most likely candidates included tuna, sharks, swordfish, whales, and giant squid. However, experts analyzed the eye based on its color, size, and structure, along with the presence of bone around the eye, and believe the orb was cut from a swordfish and tossed overboard by a fisherman. Number 10. Debris. As you may imagine, a giant churning tsunami draws up a lot of debris. After the 2011 tsunami and earthquake in Japan, lots of debris circulated in the water column and made its way into deeper waters. Subsequently, lots of marine life attached to the debris, with nearly 300 different species of fish, mussels, crabs, and various other sea creatures making their way to the United States from Japan. Much of the debris was made up of non-biodegradable plastic that had floated 6,900 kilometers or 4,300 miles with sea creatures attached. Tsunami debris has now made it possible for marine life to migrate around the world and is a new ecological process in itself. There is a danger, however, that the influx of new species could negatively affect native populations. Number 9. Faceless fish. The last time this fish was seen and recorded was in 1873. This very rare and unusual fish was hauled up from waters 1,300 feet or 400 meters deep off Australia during a scientific voyage studying parts of the ocean never explored before. This strange species of fish appeared to have no face, but a closer inspection revealed tiny eyes on the underside of its head near its mouth and buried deep beneath the skin. Scientists think it has very poor eyesight and relies more on sensory organs to navigate the deepest parts of the ocean. The fish has actually been identified as a type of cusp eel, which lives in deep waters around Indonesia, Japan, Hawaii, and the Arabian Sea. Number 8. The blob. Following the tsunami in Japan, a mysterious creature soon dubbed the blob washed up on the shore of Indonesia. The size of the creature, 20 feet or 6 meters long, caused the locals to scratch their heads as to the nature of the decaying sea monster. The identification was also made more difficult by the unexplained layer of fur covering the massive beast. These massive blobs washing up on shore have occurred in other parts of the world, and experts think they are just decomposing bodies of large whales. Try telling this to the superstitious locals. Number 7. The two-headed porpoise. Fishermen off the coast of the Netherlands were quite surprised to find a two-headed porpoise captured in their nets. This extremely rare sighting is only the 10th known case of co-joined twins in cetaceans, a group of animals that also includes whales and dolphins. The fishermen who made the discovery returned the twins, who were probably deceased, back into the ocean, much to the dismay of marine biologists who would have liked the chance to study this rare marine phenomena. Number 6. Mutant fish. The Fukushima nuclear disaster in Japan in 2011 was the direct result of the devastating earthquake and tsunami. As a result of the natural disaster, radioactive material from the nuclear power plant spilled into the ocean and has had an ongoing negative impact on marine life in the Pacific Ocean surrounding Japan and even further afield for years. It's not surprising that marine life has been affected, and there have been sightings of bizarre mutant fish supposedly caused by the radiation. Scientists think that natural ionizing radiation that occurs in oceans, coupled with human-made radiation, could change the DNA structure of sea creatures, giving them physical defects and making them appear mutated. Number 5. The fangtooth. This freaky-looking creature was found on a beach in Texas City. Although the woman who discovered it first mistook the creature for a lamprey, on closer inspection it was definitely not. Experts have weighed in on the mystery as to the identity of the creature and said it's most likely a kind of snake eel. Fang-toothed snake eels live 100 to 300 feet or 30 to 90 meters below the ocean surface and spend most of their time hiding in burrows. Strong winds, currents, and possibly tsunami-like waves are thought to carry the blame for this poor fangtooth's fate of washing up upon the beach. Number 4. Mussels, starfish, and clams. In 2012, a year after the Japanese tsunami, an 18-ton dock washed ashore in Oregon in the United States. The dock was coated in seaweed and also covered with crabs, mussels, and starfish. A tag revealed that the floating dock was from Japan. After drifting for 15 months in the Pacific Ocean, 4,000 pounds of living marine life managed to attach itself to this massive structure. The biggest ongoing fear in incidents like this is that these new species could harm local species. However, experts concur that it can take years for new marine species to establish themselves. Number 3. The oarfish. In Japan, oarfish are known as namazu, and in folklore they are thought of as a messenger of the gods. Some people believe that whenever oarfish are found washed up on beaches, either an earthquake or tsunami is about to follow, as these deep-dwelling fish rarely appear at the surface. On average, they grow up to 26 feet or 8 meters in length. They live in the deep water of temperate and tropical oceans at depths ranging from 650 feet to 3,000 feet or 200 to 915 meters. Usually, if someone spots an oarfish, it's because they've come to the surface to die. In 2010, it was reported that a dozen oarfish had washed up on Japan's coastline, and in 2011, a magnitude 9 earthquake hit Japan, triggering a giant tsunami. There have been recent sightings of oarfish washing ashore in the Philippines and Hong Kong, and that is enough to put the countries on earthquake and tsunami alert. Superstitious? Perhaps. Number 2. The beluga hybrid. Genetic testing has proven that the skull of a creature thought to be a hybrid of a beluga whale and a narwhal actually is a 50-50 hybrid. In the 1980s, a hunter named Jens Larsen killed a creature that had characteristics of both a beluga and a narwhal off the coast of Greenland. He was so amazed that he decided to keep the skull in his shed, but it was not long before the specimen found its way into the hands of researchers and scientists. DNA was extracted from the teeth of the skull, and after thorough analysis, it was discovered that it was a male born to a beluga father and a narwhal mother. Both species have been around for millennia, and it's unknown as to why or how often this interbreeding happens. Number 1. A survivor. An Indonesian man swept out to sea by an Asian tsunami survived the ordeal by living off coconuts on a leaky boat. Drifting for 2 weeks after a wave tore him from the shore, he was picked up by a passing container ship. Ari Afrizal said he was busy building a house when the tsunami struck. It first pushed him inland, then dragged him out to sea with him clutching onto a floating log. On the second day, he had the good fortune to find a leaky boat and managed to survive 2 weeks on old coconuts before being rescued. Ari is the third tsunami victim to be rescued at sea. Earthquakes and tsunamis pose one of the biggest threats to people living along the coastline. We are not yet able to predict or stop these geological phenomena, as one would use the expression, it's out of our hands. The same could be said of the marine life in our oceans, who also suffer the consequences of such environmental events. It is imperative that humanity adopts an attitude of good environmentalism for the sake of all living creatures on Earth. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Click on the notification bell for an update on our latest marine videos and stay curious.